is a bit of science has been applied to this. A suggestion that we should rip out 8 out of 10 traffic lights, and it would speed things up. This is a study by the Institute of Economic Affairs found that a 2-minute delay to every car journey that's made a year equates to, are you ready for this? This is ridiculous. An astonishing loss to the economy of around £16 billion. £16 billion, that's incredible, isn't it? Huge amount of money. And they're saying that a lot of this is down to traffic lights, because they are absolutely everywhere, aren't they? And we've all seen this, haven't we? It happens on a pretty regular basis in Hereford. Is it the Belmont Island? I think I'm pretty sure it is. The traffic lights pack up there and everyone reports on how much better the traffic is running. Seems a bit weird state of affairs, so turn them off. There's been a campaign running since 2014 to get some of these lights switched off on the A49 in Hereford. Let's talk to John Harrington from Hereford Transport Forum. Morning to you, John.
Morning, Elliot. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. Are those the lights I'm talking about? It is Belmont Island, isn't it?
It is the Belmont Island, what they call the Asda sort of roundabout now. Well, not roundabout. It was a roundabout originally, which is another point. But anyway, yes, it is the Belmont stroke Asda Junction. And there's 16 set of lights there now, I think. So
16?
16.
1-6.
1-6, yes, because there wasn't enough.
Insane. 16?
So, 16.
That's pretty much true, isn't it? Whenever they're not working, whenever they pack up, Hereford runs much more smoothly.
It was a roundabout before, Elliot, and it's now a 16-light controlled junction. So someone somewhere decided it was a good idea, but not anyone who seems to be driving in a vehicle through Hereford. Where traffic lights have been removed, and this is absolutely statistically correct, accidents have gone down. So,
well, as you're talking there, I've just noticed this. Yes, schemes in the Netherlands and in Germany scrapped 80% of their traffic lights. They've done similar things in various cities in this
Absolutely.
Country. And, accidents go down and the roads move quicker.
They move quicker because people are just simply look where they're going. They don't assume they're in a system. Green light, go. You're entitled to go. Forget about anyone else. They assume that they're travelling on a road and they've got to proceed safely, as you would if you were in the countryside. And obviously the volumes of traffic are higher, but that actually doesn't make a difference.
So if all the evidence points towards these things being a completely pointless... Well, no, they're not pointless in every case, of course they're not. The excessive use of them,
exactly,
I suppose. Let's phrase it like that. Why do we have them, then? Why?
That's a very good point. And you're right to say that there won't be a perfect solution in every case, and that's why you look at it on its merits. But the real reason, I believe, is because partly ignorance. I mean, when we first talked to the Highways Agency guys, considering these are engineers, they'd never even been involved in lights out trials. So it simply wasn't a cultural thing that they tried, but they were prepared to embrace it. The other problem is sort of demonstrated when we asked Highways Agency to send someone down to look at the lights. They sent down what they called a local contractor, which is one of the big utility companies who does their work for them. And when he came back, he said, I don't think it's a good idea. And we said, well, what does he do for a living? And he said, well, he's in charge of putting in traffic lights. So we said, yeah. So that's yeah. a sort of snapshot.
Yeah, if Turkey's voting for Christmas, isn't it, really? It's that old scenario, yeah.
It's a very expensive business. You know, so there a lot of people make a lot of money out of traffic lights.
When you talk to people about this campaign, just the general public, is the reaction fairly positive?
Almost exclusively, people say, why can't we do it? That's a great idea. Whenever the traffic lights fail, as they do at Asda, as they did the other day by the railway junction in Hereford, things go smoothly. What people tend to worry about, they think, oh, but after a certain time, people will start being discourteous and they won't be kind and they'll just go. It just simply doesn't happen. People always continue using the road as the conditions allow. And if you remove the traffic lights, I mean, one thing I would say is I'd much rather we said, look, let's drop the speed limit in the city from 30 to 20 and have no traffic lights so that when you come into Hereford, you're moving continuously, even if you're moving at a sensible, safe speed. And, you know, it could so easily be done. It reduced queues when they did it in cab stands in Bristol by something like 60%. Everyone thought it would be a ridiculous idea. It worked wonderfully well. It could work. It could work here in Hereford.
John, lovely to speak to you. Thanks a lot for that. 0345 300 8181. It is fascinating, isn't it? It does seem counterintuitive. Do you think that these lights are speeding us along our way and controlling the flow of traffic? No, often they're just making things worse. And yeah, as he pointed to several, there's lots of these surveys actually around the world, lots and lots of people. Different countries have tried these surveys and often it seems to be pointing the same way, that the fewer traffic lights you have, the better the flow of traffic.